We've made it up to the church and it took us an hour and 35 minutes from our guest house, 1 hour from like the very edge of Gergeti village all the way up. We have met another 3 dogs at the top, so there's every chance we might have 6 trail dogs with us on the way to the glacier. Or maybe this is where they all call it quits, I don't know. I hope not. I've already named 3 of them. We're about to climb up to the pass, and there's a ridge trail this way, or there's the classic trail which goes around, which is probably a bit easier and a bit shorter, but it doesn't have the views. That's if we get any views off Kazbeg. I'm hopeful that this mist will clear up though, so we're going the ridge way, dogs in tow. We've got 1.3 km to go before the best view of Kazbek Mountain. I'm skeptical, but these dogs are keeping me so happy. Doggos, thanks for the welcome party. We just passed the pass, which is a little under 3,000 meters. So it took us about 3 hours, 15 minutes from the church to get to the pass, which included about 15 minutes of debating whether to just turn around and go back. I was all for going back because there was no views and I was felt pointless. Del was like, it might clear, let's just keep going. And he won because he usually does. And now I think we've got about an hour and a half to the glacier itself. Maybe we'll get some views, maybe we won't. We should have some amazing views of Kazbegi right behind us right now, but we don't. Fingers crossed. At least we got dogs, eh? 6 dogs. Caucasus, it's fine. Let's go to the hut and eat some lunch. Starving.
Matt keeps rolling his eyes back as if he's trying to hypnotize me with his icy blue gems. It's not working, you're not getting anything.
And we've made it to the glacier. It's taken us 8.5 hours to get up here, which isn't to say it would take you that long.
No.
You spent a lot of time, you know, getting the camera out, videoing, droning, all that jazz.
Debating about whether we'll continue because of the rain.
Yeah,
luckily we did.
Talking to the dogs, all that kind of stuff. Anyway, so here it is. We've got a wee view behind us. It's been coming and going. Yeah, so it's about 2:30 in the afternoon now. So we left at 6. Actually, we're feeling all right. I've got a wee bit of a headache because it's like 3,300 metres or something here.
I'm all good.
I always suffer more than him.
So anyway, we're going to start back down, and the weather forecast is for some sunshine later on, so hopefully we'll get some good views as we're heading down.
Yeah, we had none on the way up.
Thank you.
across the river and she's been howling over there for like 2 hours. And we were about to get back to her and she finally just shows up. Oh, pup. Oh, now she's gonna have to cross her again. Well done, are you traumatized? Oh, you poor thing. Oh, well done. Oh. Okay, let's go. Let's go. We've just stopped into Alti Hut, which is super swish. They invited us in for some cha-cha, and it's apparently a very special grape. This stuff is so strong, though. I'm going to have a little bit, but we've still got a long way to go. Fourteen hours later, we're finally back in Kazbegi. It only took us about 4 hours to get back down though, instead of 8.5 hours that it took us to get back up. So to celebrate and to reward ourselves, we're having our very first Ajara Kachapuri in Georgia, which is ridiculous seeing as we've been here for 4.5 months, but Del's not a huge fan of like cheesy bread. I, on the other hand, am a massive fan, and at least I've deserved this today. Oh my goodness. Oh. Oh. Worth it.